raised us in the nurture and admonition of the Lord, and we are grateful. We honor you today. Would you stand with us this morning? We have an exciting program with the children this morning in honor of mothers on Mother's Day. And we also have a new song, a worship song, that we're going to do right out of the gate this morning. Now, it's a pretty up-tempo song, and so we're going to run through it one time slowly to teach you how the melody goes and how the words go, okay? It's called King of Majesty, all right? So if you'd stand with us, here we go. You know that I love you. You know that I want to know you so much more.
He suggests moving beyond a strict adherence to demands, requirements, and expectations to a better way of living. Serving beyond basic obligations not only reflects the spirit of Jesus, but also blesses and benefits those that have been served. We say amen to that. The principle of doing more than is requested or demanded produces a joyful spirit and freedom to live life at its fullest. And I'm sure, Russell, when you were up in this attic up in there, going across there and all the dust and dirt, you were very joyful. Amen. That was Harold up in there. St. Paul encourages all believers to offer themselves as servants to others, going beyond the required, doing more than the expected. For in doing so, remember this, it is the Lord Christ you are serving. You didn't do this for the church, although it is the church of Jesus Christ. But you did it for the Lord. The recipient of this award is being honored for demonstrating the qualities exhibited by servants in the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you for your faithful perseverance, commitment, compassion, selfless service, and Christ-like love. We honor you for graciously giving exceptional service beyond the ordinary. You are loved. The second mile award. So let me pass those out. There's also a gift in here. That's for you, Harold. There's also a gift in here from the church, just a small token of how much we appreciate what you've done. Russell, thank you so much, my brother. Thank you. These have already been lovingly framed and everything. They're ready to be hung. There's for you, Tim. Thank you, brother.
Day celebrating our mothers and grandmothers. We wouldn't be able to celebrate mothers and grandmothers if we didn't have kids. So we're also celebrating kids. So we are going to start off with our baby parade. And the babies and toddlers and kinder church kids are back there lined up with their rainbow balloons to lead us to get ready to honor our King God who is on the throne. As today is called the King's Kids. So it's an invitation for all ages to become a child of the King. So let's go ahead and let the kids lead us into worship with our baby parade.
Let's have all those parents and babies come back up front. We're going to have a special prayer for them. Beautiful. Let's have you come right across the front here, all of you.
Ryan.
Where it gets real fun. Stand right across the front. Stand in order just like the military style. No crying. Okay. We want to acknowledge Linda Case as our nursery director. What a great job she's doing. And these beautiful children. We celebrate new life, amen?
Amen.
God is pro-life, Bible's pro-life, Church of Nazarene's pro-life. In our doctrine and polity, we have a very strong pro-life statement. We believe that every life is a gift from God. And we thank you for these beautiful children and babies. Let's have a prayer. Our gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for the gift of life. And we see these little children as babes in Christ. Thank you that because of Jesus suffering and dying on the cross, that they are covered by the great grace of the Lord. And these parents, as they raise these children, may they be anointed and blessed. And there will come a day that the prevenient grace, the grace that goes before, will have been speaking and urging and working on these children. And they'll come to a knowledge that they need Jesus Christ in a personal way. And we pray, Lord, that they'll say yes to the Lord. And they'll follow the Lord all the days of their life. We thank you for them. They're a gift from you. May they continue to grow in wisdom and in the fear of the Lord and in the favor of God and man as our Lord and Savior Jesus grew. And we bless them today and thank you that you, Lord, love them. We love them too and celebrate this time in Jesus' name. You guys can all go be seated. God bless.
We are going to have some of the kids share with us a couple of songs that they've been working on with some motions to. And so before we do that, though, I just wanted to highlight an invitation for all of us. And I'm going to have Isaiah come up and get ready to share a scripture with us as well. First of all, we celebrate every day and today the family of God, because that is our forever family. And so, as a child of the King, we get to be one big family connected here on earth and in heaven. And so it's an invitation for all of us that we have to accept to be adopted into his family. And really, to keep it simple, I'm going to have Isaiah read a scripture that reminds us that this invitation is a simple invitation. It's not easy sometimes to live right, but God will give us the strength. But it's an invitation that God gives us that is the best invitation of all. So Isaiah's going to read a scripture from Matthew, and then we're going to go over our ABCs real quickly to finish offering you this invitation before the kids share.
Matthew 19:14, where Jesus said, "Let the children come to me. Don't stop them. For the kingdom of heaven belongs to those who are like these children."
Amen. So Jesus loved children. And I know sometimes children don't have as much burden as us adults allow ourselves to take on, and they can just live more carefree. And they can believe easier sometimes than us adults. And really, just that scripture is a good reminder for all of us that accepting the invitation to be a child of the King is as easy as A, B, C. We've gone over this in the kids too. And A can remind you, admit that, yes, I've made mistakes. The Bible says all have sinned against God. And that sin separates us from a relationship with God here on earth and forever in heaven. We can't have that relationship with him. We can't spend that time with him in heaven. We won't make it if we don't have that relationship that you begin by accepting. Okay? So A, admit that you have sinned. And B, believe. Believe that Jesus came from heaven. He came from heaven. God's perfect Son came down from perfect heaven to earth in this sinful, crazy world to die on the cross for our sins. So he died in our place, because the Bible says that the wages of sin is death, okay? But he died for us. So believe that he died, and that he offers you that forgiveness and a new heart. And then confess, see, confess, yes, Jesus, you are my Lord. I want to be a child of the King now and forever. I want to be able to call on you. I want to be able to just let you love me and have that relationship with me today and forever in heaven. So ABC, this is your invitation that you, if you have not accepted this invitation, today is a great day to accept this invitation. And as the kids get ready to share and celebrate that God is alive and that we belong, we can all belong to God's family and be a child of the King, as the kids celebrate with our songs today, I want you to think about this invitation. If you've already accepted this invitation, offer this invitation to others. It's the greatest invitation we can ever give, better than any birthday party invitation. So let's enjoy the kids sharing with us.
He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion. God's not.
I know there is a spiritual battle, And because of sin in the world, that's also brought disease and sickness. But I think that the enemy has working extra hard on some of our families, even within the churches, at trying to bring us down and not being able to gather together to worship, whether that be because of, you know, various sicknesses all the time. I know sickness comes and goes, but I just think that there's been an extra heart attack from the enemy. So pray with us, you know, for God's protection over all of us, and that these kids and their families will be able to continue freely worshiping and serving God, because they do an awesome job worshiping and opening up their hearts to God. So at this time, we also want to celebrate. We want to celebrate our families on earth that God has given us. And to do that, we want to celebrate our mothers and our fathers. But today we're going to especially focus on our mothers and our grandmothers. Okay? So we do have some interactive time that the kids are going to help spell out some words for us. So with that, I will have Rhea lead us into a scripture to help us think about how to honor our mothers, and then they're going to share our letters honoring our mothers and grandmothers as well.
Charm is deceptive, and beauty is fleeting, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Honor her for all that her hands have done.
Thank you very much. You guys did awesome with the scriptures and songs. And the ladies here at the church put together those hand sanitizers that has that same verse on there from Proverbs 31. So thank our church ladies for putting that together for you. And then also, I don't know if you see the pretty pink and purple flowers up here, were donated by GK's Landscaping. And every mother and grandmother is going to be able to get a flower the kids will bring out shortly to you. Okay, so first of all, I want to have the kids help me in spelling out mother and then grand for grandmothers. And then we will bring the flowers out to you as we applaud all our mothers and grandmothers in the sanctuary with us. So I'm going to call you up. The kids decorated these letters. So this is our M. We're going to start with M for mother. And they had a list of words for each letter that they could choose from that started with that letter. And that describes their mother in this case. And then when we do grandmother, those words are what they chose to describe their grandmothers. So M, we're going to have Thomas stand with our M. And go ahead and read a couple of the words that the kids chose to describe their mother.
Mighty and magnificent.
Mighty and magnificent.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Let's see, you guys will actually be over this way. Yeah. I'm trying to think how you guys are reading it. So we want to spell the word correctly, not backwards for the audience. Thank you, Tommy. And then Jacob. You have a big word. Come on up here, and you can stand by Thomas. Okay. O is for, let's say this word together, optimistic. So some of the words I had definitions for, but that means a positive person, okay? And then O is for? Out of this world cool. We got creative with some of the letters. And then T, Brandon. T is for?
Talented and makes tasty food.
Makes tasty food is the T. Talented and makes tasty food. H?
Humorous, heavenly.
Humorous and heavenly. E.
Enjoyable and educated.
Which I define as smart and knowledgeable. And they chose educated. And then R to complete our mother's word.
Be bearable, I can't count on. Reliable and righteousness.
Reliable, which we define as I can count on her, and righteous, who seeks after a right heart and relationship with God. So some big words for them to learn. You know what? If you look in the dictionary for different words, I found that there are a lot more negative words than positive words. So we had to get creative. And I think that's a pretty cool description for their mothers, that the kids had fun decorating the posters as well. And then we're going to go ahead and spell grand, grandmother. Cyprian? So the grandmas come before them, before these kids' mothers. The grandmas had to raise your parents, right? So how would you describe our grandmas?
A good cook and giving.
Good cook and giving. Notice a food theme. Isaiah, can you come up and hold the R? R is for?
Responsible and relaxing.
Responsible and relaxing. A, Jaleesa.
Awesome and active in my life.
Awesome and active in my life.
Yeah.
And N, Jade.
Nice and neat.
Nice and neat. Then to complete, I will do the D. Delightful and dearly loved. So we honor our mothers and grandmothers. Thank you, kids. And they are going to bring a flower out to every mother and grandmother here today. So if you are a mother or a grandmother, go ahead and stand up, please, and let's applause for our mothers and grandmothers that God has blessed us with. They get one of these flowers up front, and you can stay standing until you get a flower, and then when you get your flower, go ahead and sit so we know who has not received their flowers yet.
Let's have all the children. We're getting ready to move into a time of prayer around the altar. So all the children, if you all come right here and kneel at the altar, both sides here, this side right here. All of our children, thank you for sharing those verses in the presentation. And we'll look forward to seeing that skit some other time. That'll be great. Anybody else would like to come and pray? And John Mayo, where are you? Come ahead, John. We're going to anoint John this morning. He's going through some physical difficulty. So we're going to remember him in prayer. And anybody else would like to come and kneel? How about the parents coming up around these children? Let's have you come up and be beside them, behind them. Some of you come up here behind John, and we're going to lift him in prayer this morning. Amen. Amen. Let's begin over here with these children. Let's bow our heads together. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for the mothers, fathers, grandmothers, and people that have been placed in the lives of these children to direct and guide them. We thank you for their young hearts and minds. We pray for your great blessing on these children, that they will love you and serve you all the days of their life, that they will know as they've placed their faith in Jesus Christ that they are a child of the King. These are the King's kids, and that all of us are invited to come and be a part of the family of God. God doesn't want anybody to be left out. And I pray that these children will not only know their place as a child of the King, but they will desire to tell their friends. They'll want to tell other people about Jesus Christ and His love. Help them not to keep that to themselves. Help them as they come to church and they get refilled, it'll be like a refueling station, and they'll go out to school and their friends where they live, and they'll share about Christ. There'll be times when they stand up for the King that they will be persecuted. Someone will mock them and make fun of them. But they're in a long line of history of men and women and children and teenagers that have given their life for Jesus Christ. May they be faithful and true in following the Lord. Bless their parents as they raise and love them and direct them to the Lord and to the Word of God, and anoint them. And thank you again for these children. We pray, Lord, for those among us that are sick. The Bible says, if one of you is sick, to call together the elders of the church and to anoint them. And we come to you right now. And Father, we're bringing to you John. He's come forwardly, Lord, forward here, and he wants to be anointed. John, we anoint you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The anointing oil is symbolic of the Spirit of God. Holy Spirit. And as John has received some news from a doctor about his health and just some tests and uncertainty, we ask for your healing, O Father. And we thank you for doctors and medical personnel, but they don't have the last word. We thank you for their help and their training and their heart to love and to bless. But help John to know his confidence and trust is not in them. It's in the Lord. We pray for healing in John. He is your servant. Loves you. Touch him, Lord, we pray. And make him well. Thank you, Lord. We pray this morning, Father God, again for our mothers, grandmothers, people that step forward and they sacrifice their life. They give of themselves. May they be encouraged today. May mothers all over the world be encouraged today. We pray that they will sense that their responsibility and their task that has been given to them is one that is a sacred and of utmost importance. May they know that you'll empower them. May they pour out their lives, Lord, for their children and grandchildren. And we know that there are those among us that have never biologically mothered a child, but they have such a loving, motherly instinct. Bless them as well, Father, as they give of their lives to other people. We thank you for the gift of a mother. We pray you'll bless them this morning. We again pray for needs around our world where there's suffering and pain and difficulty. Let the will of the Lord be done here on earth as it is in heaven. And we will give you all the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. You may return to your seats.
As everyone is making their way back to their seats, just a couple of quick announcements. First of all, during their offering today, there's going to be a slideshow of the kids, kind of a year in review kind of look. So you'll enjoy that and just kind of seeing different things that they were able to do this past year. And the other announcements, some of you have already seen these. If you don't know, this is a pill bottle. Just so you know, pill bottle. But we are collecting these. And hopefully you're putting quarters in them. Other change can work, but quarters make it really easy and helpful. But this is a fundraiser for through our NMI to raise funds for missionaries for their medical fund. There's been some different changes with the insurance, as many of us are aware, and they have been greatly affected in their medical care as well. So as a denomination, we're going across to collecting these. You got 2 weeks, I believe, to turn them in on the 24th. So if you don't have one, you can get one. I think there's still some around you can take to have the stickers on there. But please take a part in this, as every little bit helps, and we want to do our best to support our missionaries in whatever way is possible. So with that, as our ushers make their way forward, we'll give up our tithes and offering this morning. And I also just do want to mention, too, that being Mother's Day, as we celebrate, I know it's a kind of a thing in our heart, too, that Lindsay's mother, of course, is not with us. And but I know there's many of you that your mothers have gone on to be with the Lord, or grandmothers, too. So just remembering this time, that we celebrate the good times and the fun memories, and that we honor them by just living out what they taught us. And we greatly appreciate all that they've done in our lives, too. So. And if you know someone that you're close to that maybe experienced that loss for the first time this year, it's a good day, but it can also be hard. So just, if you know someone, reach out to them, say, hey, we're thinking of you, we love you, we're praying for you too. So let's pray. Father God, we just give you thanks for this day and this time we can celebrate our kids and celebrate our mothers and just all the things that they've taught us and do for us and out of sacrifice and love. And Lord, as we give of our offering this morning, may you bless the gift and the giver, that through your generosity to us, we have seen displayed through others in our lives, and that we have the opportunity to be generous to others as well. And Lord, may this offering not only benefit the ministries of this church, but will enable us to be the hands and feet of Jesus to a broken world. And may you multiply your blessings over and over. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Sound too grave.
that we see in the Bible. And even today, leaders, we can see sometimes they make bad choices and don't follow God. So he is our example of someone who was chosen by God, but he chose not to follow God for his life, all the way through his life. However, we have another example of a king. This jewelry, huh? Okay. So, King David had seven brothers, okay? And I'm going to choose seven of you to represent the brothers, okay? So, I don't care if you're girls or boys, it's okay. So, can you go ahead and stand up? Jaleesa, can you go ahead and line up in front? And we're going to count off seven here to represent David and his brothers. So, Jaleesa, one. This is the oldest brother. Then David's other brother, and it only names a couple of the brothers. We don't have all the names in the Bible, so we'll just leave them nameless today. And Jacob, so that's, how many do we have so far, the brothers? One, two, three, four. Can you stand up and be our fifth brother? Our sixth brother? And our seventh brother. Okay, so we have seven brothers representing here today. And Samuel, it says later in the Bible, it says Samuel was a man of God who God chose to pick another king, okay? And God wanted somebody who would be king of his people and help lead people to follow after God. So Samuel's going down the line. He said, oh, yes, this looks like a great king. The oldest one, is this the right king, God? And he had to listen to God, and God said, no, you are not the right one. So go ahead and sit down. And he looked at the second brother, and the brother looked like a great king. As we looked at him physically, he looked strong, but no, God says no. God says no. God says no, that's not the one I've chosen to be king. No, and no, Tommy. So God chooses us to do different things, okay? And those brothers were not chosen to be a king leader on earth, but they are still chosen to be part of God's family. They just have a different purpose. So who did God choose to be king? So we have Isaiah. Stand up, please. Samuel said, are there any other boys that you have? Yes, I have one other boy. He's the youngest. Maybe some of you are the youngest in your family, and you think you're not as important. Well, guess where he was? He was in the fields with the sheep. So he was out all by himself taking care of all the sheep. Do you think he would have smelled very good taking care of all those sheep and out in the dirty field all day? You would have smelled handsome. Maybe to you, but to others, I don't think you would have smelled very well. So, but God doesn't care about that. He cares about, what did God look at? He didn't look at the outside, because Saul looked like a good king on the outside. But God said, yes, when David came, Samuel heard God say, yes, David is the one I've chosen to be king. You know why? Because his heart was right with God, and he was ready to serve God no matter how God wanted him to serve him, okay? And so, yes, David made mistakes, and yes, he started off kind of smelly, but God used him for great purposes. Where, how many of you, raise your hand, have ever heard the story of David and Goliath? That happened right before he became king even, okay? And so God was using him to defeat the enemy of people who fought against God's ways, okay? And so God today has used David's example. He started off as king when he was called to be king when he was very young. And he is an example to all of us that God chooses us to have a special purpose in his family. You guys can come back and sit over here. I'm going to pass out just a couple of treats. Okay, I've got a diamond, and you guys are each going to get your own diamond. Pastor John, can you stay up here and pass out these diamonds? These are not real diamonds, unfortunately, although they're very pretty like a diamond. And this diamond is going to remind all of us that each of us are very valuable and important to God, okay? Do you know where they find diamonds? In the ground. A lot of times in coal and black, ucky coal, it's hidden a lot of times, okay? And like David was out in the sheep, kind of in the smelly field with the smelly animals, it was hidden. His purpose was kind of hidden from others, but God saw his heart and knew the special purpose and valuable purpose he had for David's life. So as you look at this diamond and you look at your diamond, always remember how important you are. You're invited to be a part of God's family, and every person has an important role in God's family. Each of us are chosen to be part of his family. We just have different purposes that God can use in amazing ways. Like these diamonds are amazing to look at. And they remind us of jewels and gold in heaven. So this will be our forever home someday too. As you follow God, you'll be able to see lots of diamonds, and there'll be real diamonds. And then the other thing I have for you to remember is a ring pop. So I request that you wait to get to your seat to open them and keep your wrapper, because if you can't finish, then it takes a while to eat these ring pops unless you crunch on them. But I'm going to tell you why I'm giving you a ring pop too. Did everybody get one? Okay, let's keep our ring pops unopened right now. And just hold on to it until you get to your seat so we don't make crumbs and trash. Okay, with this ring, this is going to remind you of King David too. Kings were given, a lot of times, the princes and kings had a special ring, like a signet ring of their authority. They had power to be able to make choices, okay? And so we learned about at Easter time how God sent his Holy Spirit, right? After Jesus died on the cross and resurrected, he sent his Holy Spirit to give power. He sent down flames of fire that didn't hurt them, but gave them power to go. And from 12 guys, look at how many people were in the church all over the world. Not everybody in a church follows God, but we hear about God and can receive that invitation as we hear about him more and more and can follow him. So this ring is going to remind you that God is giving you power. He gives you power to be able to follow his word and tell others about him, and to also remind you with the diamond that you are very valuable to God, okay? And all of us are very valuable and are chosen to be part of God's family. So that's our invitation for all of you guys. And thank you for participating. And you can go back to your seats.
Triumph over them, because he is the Lord of lords and King of Kings. And with him will be his called, chosen, and faithful followers. Lord of lords and King of kings. The one that is seated on that throne is the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
And it says here in Scripture that when he comes, that he will have his called, chosen, and faithful followers. That's us. You're not a called, chosen, faithful follower just because you're religious or attend church. And as Lindsay shared very clearly, you have to admit your sin. You have to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. You have to confess with your mouth that Christ is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead. And you shall be saved. And you shall be one of these called, chosen, and faithful followers. As we close in prayer, if you don't have your faith in Christ and you would like to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and be saved, I'll extend an opportunity for you to lift your hand to the Lord and place your faith in him and be one of the King's kids. Again, Lord of lords and King of kings, Jesus Christ. Let's all stand together, all heads bowed. Many kings have come and gone. Many evil dictators and leaders. Kings that have robbed and stolen and killed and destroyed. But there stands one king who gave his life for you. Jesus Christ. He hung and died on the cross so that you might have life and have it eternal. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Would you like to be one of his called, chosen, and faithful followers? If you'd like to place your faith in Jesus Christ and become a child of the King, I would like to invite you to raise your hand to the Lord. All heads bowed. Lift your hand to the Lord. Yes. Yes. Thank you. Thank you. You can put those hands down. The Lord saw those hands. Let's pray. Thank you that the children have shared with us this great message about the King and that they are his children. Thank you for the lessons, the songs, the scriptures, seeing these babies. What a joyful day. Thank you for the mothers, grandmothers, great-grandmothers. Thank you most of all, King Jesus, that you are Lord of lords and King of kings. Our confidence and faith is not in men and women of this world. Our confidence and faith is in Jesus Christ, the coming King, who will come riding on a white horse with all of his angels, and he will make all things new, and he will receive those called, chosen, and faithful followers that will be with him forever in eternity in a place called heaven. This is not automatic. We are God's creation, but we have to put our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ to be his children, a child of the King, one of the King's kids. Remind our children that they need to know the Lord. Help them to want to know Jesus. Bless all the families and the homes that we can say, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. And as Lindsay shared with us, the spiritual attacks, even this morning, some that we would love to have been here and said, please keep us in prayer. We're going through some difficult times. We pray for protection, a hedge of protection around our families and homes. For the enemy's trying to destroy. The scripture says here that they will wage war against the Lamb. And from the beginning of time, when Satan fell from heaven, when he fell, the Bible says that he came to kill, and steal, and destroy. But Jesus said, I've come that you may have life and have it to the fullest. O King eternal, immortal, invisible, bless the families, bless this church, bless those all around the world that are following you, those that are called, chosen, and faithful. We see in the news every day, but it's not reported, that so many of these are Christians that are martyred for their faith. We lift them to you, Lord. They're the called, chosen, and faithful. And whatever small amount of persecution we may be facing here in this nation at this time, oh Lord, it pales in comparison to people that are told to renounce the name of Jesus, or they will be beheaded, or their life will be taken, or their family will be stripped of them, and they'll go to prison. We remember them, Lord. We pray we may be your servants. You are the King. We honor you this day. Those that lifted their hands, Lord, may they place their faith in Jesus Christ as their Savior. Follow him all the days of their life. And we thank you again for this time today. Be together. What a blessing. And we ask it all in the strong name of the Lord of Lords and King of Kings, Jesus Christ. Amen, amen. And amen. God bless you. You are dismissed.